All right, it doesn't matter where we've been, because it's time for episode 10 and 11. Okay, it's time to get the Survivor review back on track, and that means getting it back on time. So this week, to catch up, I'm giving you a double-barreled episode. So before we get into episode 10, let's check in on Ponderosa and see what's going on over there. Artis comes in looking like a homeless man and smelling like a freshly cut onion, but he's still got a smile on his face, and that's what I like about him. Now, Artis and Jeff Kent both know that their game is over, so they can be friendly with one another. RC, on the other hand, is suffering from PTSD. That's post-traumatic survivor disorder. She just can't let things go. Anyway, back to Survivor proper. Episode 10 starts out with Abi Maria saying, "You know what? I feel bad for the artist. Okay, I'm over it." Not So Vanilla Pete says, "Well, I guess that's what happens when you fall asleep at the wheel." All right, Not So Vanilla Pete, just don't let it happen again. There are no days off on Survivor. So after Abi Maria has had time to digest what had happened at Tribal Council, she gets kind of pissed.
"Like, what the
fiddlesticks?
I thought we agreed that
ta-dang-a-dang, ka-dang-a-dang, ka-dang
was supposed to stick together."
So Abi Maria realizes she needs to solidify Lisa's vote. So the two of them have a little chat. And this is when Lisa reveals that she's very comfortable being used by people in her life in general, which is pretty sad. But on the bright side, I could definitely use somebody like Lisa in my alliance when I play Survivor. You just give her a little sugar and that train will run all day. Anyway, Lisa's telling Abi Maria that, "Well, I'm not with you anymore. I'm against you." And Abi says,
"No, no, no, you should be with us."
And Lisa's like, "No, I'm with them." And Abby's like,
"Okay, okay, I am done. I am done trying. I try really hard for you, but I am done now. This is me being done. Cannot you see? I am bending over backwards for you. But no more, no more, no more. You are with them. Good luck with that. Knock it out of my face!"
So up next is the reward challenge, or as I like to call it, the Special Olympics. Now this challenge is a team challenge. You have a red team and a yellow team. On the red team, it's Carter, Malcolm, and Not So Vanilla Pete. On the yellow team, you have Lisa, Jonathan, and Denise. Now Mike Scoopin and Abi Maria are playing for both teams. So after Abi Maria scores a point for the opposing team, Jeff Probst asks her, "Are you clear on what's happening here?" Now before we jump all over Abi Maria here, cut her some slack. She doesn't normally play in challenges. So when it's all said and done, the red team wins a day at the spa. So Malcolm, Abi Maria, Not So Vanilla Pete, and Carter are on reward. And Malcolm calls it a strategy-free zone. No game talk. And Not So Vanilla Pete agrees. "Didn't you just say something about falling asleep at the wheel? This is Survivor, so guess what? Day 40 is your first day off." So anyway, the spa day concludes and the winners go back to camp. And Abi Maria wants to share the experience with everybody.
"I felt like it was an oasis in a desert, this camp being a desert. Oh, I feel like I'm 3 months pregnant from eating so much. What did you guys eat today? Oh, 3 spoonfuls of rice, very nice. I was eating like a crazy woman, which some of you would say goes without saying. You know, it was pretty amazing. I felt like princess. The view was breathtaking. It was like from magazine. Very different than this hellhole here. They had calamari and a fruit basket to die for. Amazing. It was like the rice you're eating right now, only totally different. When I was here at camp, I felt like peasant, like you guys. And then it was like a fairy went ding and I became the Cinderella.
So this is getting under everybody's skin. And Denise, you know, the witch, she says she can't wait to write Abby's name down. And when she does, she's gonna say, "Whiners are wieners." So at this stage in the game, it's pretty smart to lock down your end game. Malcolm wants Lisa, Michael, and Denise in his final four. And Lisa wants Mike and Jonathan in her final three. But for some strange reason, Jonathan's not committing to anything. Jonathan, how many times have you played this game before? Just tell her what she wants to hear. If you don't follow through on it, you can pick up the pieces later. So since Jonathan is non-committal, Lisa makes a final four deal with Mike, Denise, and Malcolm. So sorry, Jonathan. As Denise would say, snoozers are losers. Now, just in case you guys missed it, during Malcolm's pre-season interview, he said he wanted to play this game like Brian Heidick. Well, Malcolm, you're not. You see, Brian Heidick aligned with Clay, and the equivalent to Clay this season is Abby Maria. You're playing the Colby, I want to be second place game. So up next is the immunity challenge. Now, I don't know if you guys were paying attention to my excessively long hashtag last week, but I know Phil Smith was. So what you need to do is follow him on Twitter. Anyway, the immunity challenge comes down to two guys. Carter and Mike Scoopin. So does Mike win immunity? Not today! You know, like not, like, because they had to feed the buoy through knots. So it's Carter that wins immunity. So back at camp, Abby and not-so-vanilla Pete realize they're in trouble. So they devise a plan to blindside Malcolm. And everybody else decides to split their votes between Abby Maria and not-so-vanilla Pete. So that way they're going to get rid of Abby Maria and her immunity idol, or not-so-vanilla Pete and Abby Maria's immunity idol. So then it's off to tribal, and this one's not going to be pretty. Everybody gangs up on Abby Maria, and she starts to cry. Now, English might not be her first language, and nice might not be her first emotion, but I'm not the kind of person to jump on a bandwagon. So when everybody's jumping all over Abby Maria, I actually start to like her. Besides, she makes my job a whole lot easier. She's the gift that keeps on giving. So when it's all said and done, Abby Maria plays her idol, not-so-vanilla Pete votes for Malcolm and puts XOXO under it, which means hugs and kisses, and not-so-vanilla Pete gets sent to Ponderosa. So you got a double-barreled Survivor review for episodes 6 and 7. Why not do the same for episodes 10 and 11? So of course the episode starts out with a recap of last week's show, and we're reminded that Abby Maria gets beat down at Tribal Council, to the point where she's like, "Tribal Council, get out of my face!" But this week, she's gearing up for a fight. So instead of the reward challenge this week, we get the Survivor Auction. And the rules are simple. You get $500, and you can bid on any item you want. You just can't share money with other survivors to bid on an item. And you can't share the item you bid on. Unless your name is Carter. Now, on a side note, am I the only person who's ever thought that the Survivor Auction needs to be sponsored by eBay? You guys are just leaving money on the table. I'm just saying. Anyway, by the end of the auction that's not sponsored by eBay, the survivors fill up their little tummies. Abby Maria buys herself an advantage in the next immunity challenge, and Carter gets screwed twice. Both times Carter bought something, he ended up sharing it with the tribe. Now, if I was playing in this season of Survivor, I would have voted Carter out at the next Tribal Council. It would have been funny. What can I say? I have a mean streak. You gotta keep things spicy. Keep it interesting. Sometimes life needs a little dash of Tabasco. Besides, the guy's a challenge threat. It's gotta go anyway. So the survivors go back to camp, and Abby Maria wants to clear the air.
Cannot you see? At last Tribal Council, I was demoralized. I was pointed fingers at. I was gangbanged. This made me cry. Now Peeners, Jonathan Peeners, I want an apology, so make it happen.
Now Abby Maria is definitely not getting any apologies from anybody, but what she does have is an advantage at the next immunity challenge, because that's what she bought at the Survivor Auction. And she's trying to leverage that into something more than it really is.
The clue led me to a genie, and that genie gave me an immunity idol. And that genie gives me an advantage in next immunity challenge. Very believable.
Now, I don't think anybody's buying that Abby has a fourth phantom idol, but at least she's trying, which is more than I could say for everybody else. Everybody else is playing the Colby Donaldson Survivor Outback game. Ah, yes, let's only bring the deserving to the end. And then after that, every man for himself. God bless America. Are you kidding me? Malcolm has an idol in his pocket. Mike Scoopin is Survivor royalty. Denise is a machine. Carter is a challenge threat. And none of these people are on anybody's radar. It's nuts to me. And don't get me wrong, I love this cast, but Abby Maria is the only one strategizing at this point. Anyway, let's go to the immunity challenge. God bless America. Now, there's been a lot of discussion. Does God watch Survivor, or does God not watch Survivor? Well, I think this immunity challenge proves beyond a shadow of a doubt that God does watch Survivor, and he likes his Survivor interesting, because Abby Maria wins immunity. Now, since no one can vote Abby Maria because she has immunity, Jonathan and Denise are on the hot seat going into Tribal Council. Now, I like Jonathan, but I have no sympathy for him in this game. This is his third time playing, and he has no plan B, no plan C, no plan Z. I couldn't even tell you what Jonathan's plan A is in this game. So Jonathan whistles his way off to Ponderosa, and here are a couple of my Ponderosa thoughts. Number one, the more I see of RC on Ponderosa, the more I like Abby Maria. Number two, why don't they let Artis wear his headphones at Tribal Council? And number three, I was really looking forward to Jeff Kent telling everybody that he was a Major League Baseball player. But that's a missing plot point at Ponderosa. So that's it for this week. What you need to do is hit the subscribe button right up here. You need to follow me on Twitter, Tout, and Facebook at Survivor Trev. And I want to thank the specialist Philip Shepard and Christina Cha for retweeting the link to last week's show. We've only got three more episodes to go, and I'll see you guys in episode 12.